other spider has a star cloud named after it. And wherever they live, we've given tarantulas their own special names. Bird-eating spider, king baboon spider, or earth tigers. But what makes a tarantula? Fact is, they're the oldest spiders on the planet and have venomous fangs to rival many snakes. To scientists, they're known as the primitive spiders of the family Theraphosidae. And they all have a unique combination of five characteristics. Number one, they are very hairy. Number two, at the ends of their eight long legs, they have dense hair pads and retractable claws like a cat. Number three, their spinnerets are extremely long and shaped like fingers. Number four, they have hundreds of black studs around their mouthparts. Scientists call them cuspules, and they're used to crush food. And number five, they have no fewer than eight eyes in rectangular position, but remain almost blind. While other spiders might own one or two of these, only tarantulas have all five. Primitive spiders are the creators of silk. These ancient weaving masters can produce four different kinds of silk strands. Silk is a natural antibiotic and keeps their underground homes perfectly clean. They use it to line and strengthen their burrows. From their doorstep, they lay out a welcome mat of delicate trip lines which work like an early warning system. While out of sight in its burrow, the spider can detect any movement around. To find her, he senses the ground for her smell or pheromones. If she's ready for romance, she's laid down a specially scented silk that will lead him to the lady in residence. Immediately he starts courting her with a kind of tap dance. His sperm is charged in the dark bulbs on his pedipalps, which have become his sexual organs. Determined to lure her out, he continues to drum home his mating message, even though she might grab him for dinner instead. He is programmed to mate and nothing, not even her dangerously bad temper, holds him back. A less than welcoming attack abruptly ends their first embrace. Far from put off, he's willing to prove he's got what it takes. Finally, his rhythmic advances pay off, and she emerges from her burrow. He still can't be sure of her. She's liable to strike at any time. So he takes up his tapping routine again, just to be sure. Rearing up, she's an impressive sight, towering over her smaller suitor. He quickly tries to couple with her. But it's an awkward maneuver and often takes several attempts. Finally, success. The tip of his bulb penetrates and he injects his sperm. And that's where the love match ends. If he's lucky, he'll escape the dinner date. Female tarantulas sometimes dine on their mates post-coitally, but either way, his fate is sealed. If he's still keen on romance, he'll have to look elsewhere. But his time is running out, males die shortly after their first and only mating season. It's the females that live on, and they're the ones in demand. Prowling insects make a tasty bite. Hidden at the entrance, the spider can sense every step of its wandering prey. The vibrations of the silken radar system signal the whereabouts and size of the potential meal. Usually, tarantulas sit and wait in ambush until the prey comes close to them. But if they're really hungry, they'll venture out and stalk their food. Within the blink of an eye, the spider pounces and impales its prey on its deadly fangs. Once back in the burrow, it takes its time to prepare the kill. While the injected venom paralyzes and slowly liquefies the prey's inner organs, many spiders will lay down a silky feeding mat. It's not yet known why, but it seems to be a spidery form of food wrapping, providing packaged meals which can be stored away and tucked into later. Spiders can't eat solid food. With no jaws and only a tiny slit-like mouth between their fangs, they rely on their venom to turn their prey's innards into a creamy, highly nutritious soup. They use their powerful sucking stomach to drink up the carcass. One big meal can last for months. Tarantulas are carnivores and not fussy. Many are known as bird-eating spiders, but in fact, birds are rarely on the menu. Just about anything else, small and alive, is.